बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। माय नेम मोहम्मद अहमद, माय आईडी इज 003 एंड माय डिपार्टमेंट इज बीएस केमिस्ट्री फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर एंड टुडे आई एम हियर टू प्रेजेंट माय प्रेजेंटेशन एंड माय टॉपिक इज न्यूक्लियर फिजन एंड न्यूक्लियर फ्यूजन। सो हियर द contents for nuclear fission and nuclear fusion are different. We will cover the nuclear fusion, mechanism of nuclear fusion, uses of nuclear fusion, advantages and disadvantages of nuclear fusion. And in nuclear fusion, requirements of the fusion reaction, uses of nuclear fusion, advantages and disadvantages of nuclear fusion. So first of all, we will see what is fission. The nuclear reaction in which one heavier nucleus is split into two lighter nuclei of almost equal size with the release of huge amount of energy is called nuclear fission or atomic fission. Let's see its history. Nuclear fission was first discovered on December 17, 1938 by German Otto Hahn, and secondly explained theoretically in January 1939 by Lise Meitner and her nephew Otto Robert Fisch. Nuclear fusion, as we can see, in which incident neutron react with fusionable nucleus, then it break and split into two nucleus. By splitting this, a huge amount of energy is released and further this process go away. The splitting of nucleus causes the formation of different smaller fragments. These fragments are about equal to half the original mass, two or three neutrons, and large amount of energy also released. It is responsible for all types of power generation, like in nuclear power plants and around nuclear weapons. Uranium is the most common element used in nuclear fission. Uranium-235 is the most commonly used isotopes of uranium for nuclear energy production. But the question, what happens when a neutron is bombarded to uranium-235? An unstable nucleus of uranium-236 forms undergo fission. Smaller nuclei are produced, such as krypton-92 and barium-141. These three neutrons are released to bombard more uranium-235. The number of neutrons released determine the source of chain reaction, in addition to that huge amount of energy released. Here we can see the nuclear fission reaction in which neutron react with uranium-235 to form the barium and krypton and three neutrons plus energy. Here same process remains constant. Neutron react with uranium-235 by doing this huge amount of energy released, by which two products are formed, krypton and barium. Also, again the neutron react with uranium-235, and again this released a huge amount of energy, and byproducts are krypton and barium. And fission is exothermic. The amount of energy released in nuclear fission can be calculated by mass defect method. In fission reaction, the total mass of product is always less than the mass of lagging nuclei. This decrease in mass is called mass defect, which is converted into energy, and mass energy relationship according to Einstein's equation is E=mc². Mechanism of nuclear fission liquid drop model suggested by Bohr-Miller. Since an atomic nucleus has many similarities with the liquid drops, a liquid drop has a spherical shape due to its surface tension. If sufficient energy is applied on the drop to overcome the force of surface tension, the drop may change its spherical shape into elliptical shape. If the external force is large, elliptical shape may be changed into dumb ball shape and break into two portions of spherical shapes. Here, spherical shape is uranium, external force neutrons. The energy absorbed by uranium nucleus to change from spherical shape to critical shape is called threshold energy. सिंस टू पार्ट्स ऑफ क्रिटिकल शेप हैव पॉजिटिव चार्ज, दे रिपेल फ्रॉम ईच अदर एंड सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर फॉर्मिंग टू स्फेरिकल शेप ऑफ सेम साइज. हियर वी कैन सी द न्यूट्रन न्यूट्रन स्फेरिकल शेप स्फेरॉइडल, देन इट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू डंबल शेप एंड देन इट्स सेपरेटेड इनटू टू ड्रॉपलेट्स. यूजेस ऑफ न्यूक्लियर फिशन. The enormous energy liberated in nuclear fission and the occurrence of chain reaction have been used in atomic bomb. Atomic bomb. Each uranium 235 liberates 3 neutrons called secondary neutrons. Each neutron will strike on the another fresh uranium 235 nucleus and cause further reaction. Some of the neutrons will escape into the air, cause no reaction and explosion. The size of uranium 235 nucleus, which is smaller than critical size, is called supercritical size. If it is in this condition, the large number of neutrons were captured by uranium 235 nucleus and cause large explosion and chain reaction. The atomic bomb consists of thousands of pieces of uranium. At the time of explosion, these three driven together and these subcritical size of uranium 235 will combine together and will form one large piece of supercritical size. Now neutrons from other source will strike on this large piece of uranium and cause rapid chain. This reaction causes a violent explosion with the releasing of vast amount of energy. Advantages. It helps minimize environmental pollution. This means they can provide heat, electricity, and power to consumer without producing lots of carbon dioxide emission. It helps to reduce global warming. Nuclear fission, there would be less greenhouse gases in the atmosphere as a result of greenhouse effect would be felt less, and global warming would be stopped or at less reduced. It can keep up with energy demands. Nuclear plants can produce high amounts of energy, fission energy. This can be good thing in today modern times, wherein the demand for energy is steadily rising as more and more people drive cars, build houses, use electronic devices, and do other energy intensive activities. When we talk about its advantages. It can be dangerous for employees. Radiation, which is one of the byproducts of nuclear fission, can be harmful to people if they are exposed to it at large amounts. It can be dangerous for communities. Waste byproducts pollutes the environment, but will also endanger the lives of people who live near the disposable sites. Nuclear plants are also highly volatile. If an accident occurs, they can explode and affect the surrounding areas and communities. It has high initial expense, and nuclear plants need specialized equipment and machinery before they can become fully functional, and therefore require millions of dollars to be built. The plants also need to put safety measures in place to protect their workers and the surrounding areas, and these measures can cost a significant amount of money. When we talk about fusion reaction, nuclear fission is a process by which multiple nuclei join together to form a heavier nucleus. It is accomplished by the release or absorption of energy depending on mass of the nuclei involved. It is also called thermonuclear reaction, in which we can form deuterium, tritium, helium, and neutron form a requirements of fusion reaction. Plasma temperature 10 to 20 million Kelvin. A plasma is microscopically neutral collection of charged particles needed to overcome neutral positive deposit forces of plasma ions. Energy coefficient. Coffinment times 4 to 6 seconds. The energy of Coffinment times is a measure of how long the energy in plasma is retained before being lost. Third one is central density in plasma. Large density region become because number of fusion reactions per unit volume is roughly proportional to the square of the density. Uses of nuclear fuel in hydrogen bomb. The principle of nuclear fuel is used in a hydrogen bomb. The temperature required for the purpose of fusion is produced by fusion reaction. The explosion of an atom bomb produces temperature of the order of 50 million degrees Celsius. A suitable assembly of the deuterium and tritium is arranged at the site of the explosion of the atom bomb. Favorable temperature initiates the fusion of the light nuclei in uncontrolled manner. This releases enormous amount of heat energy. The fusion reaction in hydrogen bomb is the, this is the production. This is the production of tritium from the lithium deuteride. Advantage. Nuclear fusion does not create harmful waste. Nuclear fusion only has the creation of helium as the byproduct. Helium is non-toxic, safe, and won't create the same environmental damage that is burning of the fossil fuels can create. It is incredibly inexpensive to create. The estimated cost of providing energy throughout nuclear fusion is just $0.03 per kilowatt hour. This makes it one of the cheapest form of energy that humans have ever discovered. Now talk about disadvantages. It requires almost as much energy to create a nuclear fuel to fuse two atoms together. High levels of heat are required in order to create the heat, a large energy investment must be made. This industry still requires innovation. The high levels of heat that are required to create nuclear fusion means that we need materials available that can withstand those temperatures to create energy. With our current technology, we have no knowledge of a specific material that can withstand the heat necessary to create fusion. That's all from my side. Thank you.